Allah says in this ayah, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالصَّبِرْ عَلَيْهَا لَا نَسْأَلُكَ رِزْقًا نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكَ وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلتَّقْوَى. In this ayah, Allah commands the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to direct his family, his wife and his children to perform salah, and for him also to be persistent and to have sabr on following what he has commanded the people to do. وَالصَّبِرْ عَلَيْهَا لَا نَسْأَلُكَ رِزْقًا نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكَ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, I am not asking you for provision to provide, I am the one who is providing for you. This ayah of course indicates that each person is responsible for the people who are under him, his wife and his children. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. Allah says to the believers, protect yourself and your families from a hellfire that is ignited by people and stone. And this is one point. The other point is that following the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like the salah, is one of the means of provision and wealth, even in this dunya. Wealth has certain means. There's asbab dunyawiyya wa asbab shara'iyya. There are worldly means, which we all know, to study, to work hard, right? To trade with intelligence and skill. And there are asbab shara'iyya, which are means that are only known through the Quran and Sunnah, in which you are told, if you do this, Allah will provide you with this. So this hadith here, this ayah here, indicates that salah is one of them. Can we give other examples of other things in the shara' in which you are told, if you do it, Allah will provide for you? At-taqwa, this is important. Where is the ayah? أمن واتقوا لفتحنا عليهم بركات من السماء ومن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. صح. Also الاستغفار, من لزم الاستغفار جعل الله له من كل ضيق فرجا, من كل ضيق مخرجا, ومن كل هم فرجا, ورزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. What other means? الصيام, ما أذكر أن في حديث مع الصيام بيربطه بالرزق. الزكاة, giving money, الصدقة والزكاة. And like what is, يمحق الله الربا ويربي الصدقات. سبحان الله, look at the ayah, ويربي الصدقات. ربا from the same root, from the same root. So he didn't say يربي الله الربا, يمحق الله الربا. And for the, and you did ربا, ربا means to increase. You did riba with the purpose of increasing. Allah in this ayah tells us where the real increase is. Is in sadaqat. وَيُرْبِي الصَّدَقَات. Also, one time Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was giving so much money out, and then somebody said to him, this is enough, you're giving too much money out. And Bilal of course was his servant, so he was giving the money on his behalf, giving, going around giving to people. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam responded to this man who was giving him advice not to give out so much. And he says to Bilal, أنفق بلالا ولا تخشى من ذي العرش إقلالا. أنفق بلالا ولا تخشى من ذي العرش إقلالا. And he says من ذي العرش mean the holder of the throne, or the king of the throne, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, indicating because Allah controls everything and he is the king. So he can, although it looks on the outside picture that your money is lessening, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by some means can make it increase. Also he told to Asma, Ya Asma, anfiqi yunfaq alayki wa la tuki fayuka alayki. Give so that Allah may spend, so that Allah may spend on you, and do not withhold so that Allah does not withhold from you. that Allah does not. Also, Allahumma a'ti munfiqan khalfa. And so, especially the giving, as you see, is mentioned many ahadith. What other examples of things? Naam, and this is also on the sadaqah. Another thing, another act of worship where there's risk. هذا مش حديث ولكن طلب العلم بصفة عامة to learn the Islamic knowledge that is a means of risk. Why is that? There's a hadith in which a man and his brother, one of them used to work and the other one used to sit and listen to the Prophet ﷺ to learn the Sunnah and Quran. So the man who was working one time went to Prophet ﷺ to complain. He says, you know, my brother is always sitting in the masjid listening, and I'm the one who's working hard in the sun, you know, and I'm tired. So he said to him, لَعَلَّكَ تُرْزَقُ بِهِ. He says, you're probably being provided for because of him, because of your brother who's learning the Quran and the Sunnah. You have a hadith? نعم شرف الرحم يا فليصل رحمه يا this is to be nice and kind to your relatives. That's another way, whether by money or by word, by visiting, all these kind of, this is a means of increase in rizq. من صبره أن يبسط له في رزقه وينسأ له في عمره فليصل رحمه. And there's a hadith that indicates that صلة الرحم is so strong in providing rizq. Just the meaning of the hadith or the last part of the hadith, Prophet ﷺ says, وَإِنَّ الْقَوْمَ لَيَكُونُونَ فُجَّارًا فَتَكْثُرَ أَمْوَالُهُمْ فَتَزْدَادَ أَمْوَالُهُمْ وَتَكْثُرَ أَوْلَادُهُمْ إِذَا وَصَلُوا رَحِمَهُمْ. Even he says people can be very evil, but since they are very nice to each other and to their families, their money and their children will increase just because of Silat Ar-Rahim, even if they are in other parts are not very good. Another one is Hajj and Umrah. تابعوا بين الحج والعمرة فإنهما ينفيان الفقر فإنهما ينفيان الفقر كما ينفي التير خبث الحديد. To repeat Hajj and Umrah, and as you see there's money, paying money. You go Hajj and Umrah, how much you pay? Thousands every time. And this is another indication that it will remove. And then dua, of course. A man came to Prophet ﷺ one time and told him that I have so many debts on me, I don't know what to do. And then he taught him the hadith, اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الهم والحزن وأعوذ بك من العجز والكسل وأعوذ بك من الجبن والبخل وأعوذ بك من غلبة الدين وقهر الرجال فلزمها الرجل فقضى الله عنه دينه. The man kept on saying it. You have to say it day and like in the morning and in the evening. Azkar al-sabah wa azkar al-masa. This dua specifically is mentioned. And there are some other things. Jihad, for instance, is a means of rizq. وَجُعَلَ رِزْقِ تَحْتَ ظِلِّ رُمْحِ وَجُعَلَ رِزْقِ تَحْتَ ظِلِّ رُمْحِ. So there are so many means of rizq. Hijrah to migrate to a Muslim state. If there's a Muslim state, if there was a Muslim state, to migrate from the state of kuffar to the state of Muslimin. Allah says, وَمَنْ يُهَاجِرْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ يَجِدْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُرَاغَمًا كَثِيرًا وَسَعًا. يَجِدْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُرَاغَمًا كَثِيرًا. مُرَاغَمًا means means of worshipping Allah. وإغاظة الشيطان, إرغام الشيطان. مراغما means إرغام الشيطان, to make شيطان angry with you. How do you make شيطان angry with you? By obeying Allah. يشف الأرض مراغما كثيرا وسعة, ساعة في الرزق. ساعة في الرزق وساعة هنا يعني عامة, قيل ساعة في الرزق وساعة في العلم وساعة في الدين, ساعة في يعني في المسكن, يعني كل حاجة زي ما حصل مع الصحابة. يعني الصحابة were very poor, but when they made the hijrah they became very, very rich eventually, right? Shall we stop here? مش ما أزعى عن صحة هذا الحديث, ولكن بالذات في حديث المتعلقة بفضائل السور يجب يعني الانتباه, لأن كثير منها ضعيف. كثير من ذلك يعني بعض العلماء ألف في صحيح أسباب النزول وصحيح فضائل السور, لأنه من الأبواب اللي فيها كثير من الأحاديث الضعيفة, فواحد ينتبه لفضائل السور.
Mm-hmm.